वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स इन द सेकंड लेक्चर ऑन क्लासिफिकेशन एंड टेबुलेशन। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टडीड द डेफिनेशन ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन, देन ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन एंड द टाइप्स ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन। इन द टाइप्स ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन वी स्टडीड क्वांटिटेटिव क्लासिफिकेशन, क्वालिटेटिव क्लासिफिकेशन, जियोग्राफिकल क्लासिफिकेशन एंड क्रोनोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन। टुडे वी आर स्टडिंग सम डेफिनेशंस ऑन दिस क्लासिफिकेशन। टुडेज फर्स्ट डेफिनेशन इज फ्रीक्वेंसी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। अ सिस्टमेटिक प्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ the values taken by a variable along with their frequencies are called frequency distribution. A systematic presentation of the values taken by a variable with their frequencies are called frequency distribution. Now here question comes, what is mean by frequency? So the number of times an observation is repeated is called frequency. For example, in the data the observation 5, the value 5 is repeated 10 times, so 10 is the frequency of 5. Then next definition is class frequency. The number of observations corresponding to a particular class is known as the class frequency. Now class frequency is positive integer including 0, that is the class frequency may be 0, 1, 2, 3, 10, 5, 20, 30, whatever, it is an integer including 0. For example, here the distribution of height of the student is the height in centimeter and number of students. Here the class is 140 to 150 and the frequency or number of students are 6. Similarly, 150 to 160, 24, 160 to 170, 18, 170 to 180, 2. Here these 6, 24, 18, 2 are the class frequencies corresponding to the particular class, that is nothing but class frequency. Then the next definition is discrete frequency distribution. While framing a frequency distribution, if class intervals are not considered is called discrete frequency distribution. While framing a frequency distribution, if the class intervals are not considered, then it is called as discrete frequency distribution. For example, the number of families according to the number of children are distributed as follows: number of children and number of families. Suppose there are 10 families who are having no children, or there are 40 families who are having one child, there are 80 families who are having two children, or there are 20 families who are having three children. This is nothing but the discrete frequency distribution. Why? Because it considered the discrete values, that is 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. The next definition is continuous frequency distribution. While framing a frequency distribution, if class intervals are considered is called continuous frequency distribution. While framing a frequency distribution, if class intervals are considered is called continuous frequency distribution. For example, we'll see the distribution of weight of persons. Here, weight in kilogram and number of persons. Weight in kilogram 30 to 40, there are 10 persons. 40 to 50, 15 persons. 50 to 60, 40 persons. 60 to 70, 45 persons. 70 to 80, 20 persons. Now here, while framing a frequency distribution, we considered the class intervals along with their frequencies. So this is called as continuous frequency distribution. Now next concept we have to study here is formation of discrete frequency distribution. Here the three columns are formed in formation of discrete frequency distribution, and those columns are variable, tally bars and frequency. In the first column, values of given variable are written without repetition in an order. In the first column, that is variable column, values of given variable are written without repetition in an order. Without repetition in an order means, suppose first value is 0, then next 1, 2, 3 and so on. This sequence we have to write the given observation. What are the given observations? Those observations without repetition we have to write in the first column. Then for each value, tally is marked against that value in the second column. In the data, what value is given, for that every value, one tally we have to mark in front of that observation in the second column, that is tally mark. In this way, tally scores are marked against for all values, and for EG counting, the tallies are put as a group of 5. Finally, count the number of tally bars corresponding to each value of the variable, and that we have to write in the third column. It is known as frequency. The total frequency is n, and that is equal to the total number of observations. Now let's see this formation of discrete frequency distribution with an example. Here the example is, in a survey of 40 families in a certain locality, the number of children per family was recorded and the following data were obtained. So here the number of children per family are given, and there are 40 families. The data is 1, 0, 3, 2, 1, 5 and so on. It is up to 2, 4, 5. 40 number of observations are there. Represent the data in the form of discrete frequency distribution. This data we have to represent by discrete frequency distribution. Now let's see how to represent this data by discrete frequency distribution. In the solution, we have to write frequency distribution of the number of children, and we have to prepare a table. The first column is number of children, and it is denoted by x. X is a variable. Then second column is tally marks, and last column is frequency, and frequency is denoted by f. Now you can observe the first observation, it is 1. Second observation is 2. Third observation is 3 and so on. First is 1, 0, 3. Now, first observation is 1. Then we have to mark one tally in the column in front of 1. So here, one tally. Next observation is 0. So one tally in front of 0. Next observation is 3. So one tally in front of 3. Like this, we have to continue for all the observations, or to simplify, count the total number of zeros in the data. If you count the total number of zeros in the data, there are 3 zero values. So give 3 tally marks in front of 0. If you count one observation in the data, then there are 7 observations. So we have to give 7 tallies in front of 1. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1 cross tally for easy counting. These are 5 observations, but total 1 values are 7. Then give another 2 tallies here. So total there are 7 tally marks. So write 7 in the frequency. Similarly, continue this procedure of giving tally marks for all the observations and count the number of tallies and write as a frequency. Here 3 number of tallies, so frequency is 3. Here 7 tally marks, so frequency is 7. Here 5 plus 5, 10 tallies, so frequency is 10. Here 5 plus 3, 8 observations, so frequency is 8. Here 5 plus 1 is 6, so frequency is 6. Here 4 observations, so frequency is 4. Here 2 observations, so frequency is 2. And if we add all these frequencies, then you will get capital N is equal to 40, and N equal to 40 is nothing but the total number of observations given in the question, because we have the question regarding 40 families. So N is equal to 40. So this is the formation of discrete frequency distribution. In the next class, we will solve some more examples on formation of discrete frequency distribution. Thank you.